Hello, hello, what's up guys? It's Pixelated Apollo, thanks for stopping by, and today we are playing Napoleon Total War. So I hope you guys have your muskets and you're ready to join the firing line. So this is a subscribers battle replay, it's a 2v2, we have two Ottoman armies, and they are taking on Great Britain in Russia. And this is a really cool map, as you can tell, it's very strategic. There's a lot of different defensive positions. Obviously in the center you can see some cliffs, and then in between the center, in between the cliffs, you have lots of trees over here which you can use to set up ambushes or retreat and get a more defensive position, because the trees will protect your men from enemy fire. So I think the map's called Italian Grassland, so pretty cool, pretty fun. Now, before this battle gets too spicy, gets too crazy, I don't want to miss any of the action. We're going to keep it in slow motion, and we're going to check out these army comps. So, starting with the Ottoman Empire, there's two units of the Janissary Grenadiers, which this unit is a very solid unit, very good at fighting in melee, and also firing from a distance. He's got four units of Gemet Janissaries, a nice melee focused unit there, and then he has four units of the Jedid line infantry, or Jedid infantry, so that's his line infantry there, and then he has three units of the Jedid rifles, so it's good to bring some skirmishers, very very important on the Napoleonic battlefield. He has some Bashi bazooks with the nice baby blue uniforms, and then over here he's bringing lots and lots of cav, which is good because, you know, that's the strength, or one of the strengths of the Ottoman Empire. Here's his general, here is two units of the Silatar Guard, very cool, heavily armored cav. And then he also has some Delhi cav, which is currently running through the center. And then way back here, I wanted to show you this unit last, because look at this. He's got some camel gunners. And look at the eyes. Look at the eyes of these camels. What in the world? It's daylight, and they are glowing. This is very, very bizarre. What kind of beast is this? Demon camel riders. Moving on to the next Ottoman army. He's got two units of Jedid rifles, mounted Jedid units here. And then over here, he has more deadly cav, the Delhi horsemen, two units of the Sipahi cav, and he's mostly bringing Jedid line infantry. He also has some light infantry as well, so about three units with lots of chevrons there, so very experienced. He's got the auxiliaries over here, which is a pretty cool unit, which we don't see all the time. They're lower tier infantry, so about two units of them. And then over here, here's his four units of Jedid infantry. There we go. So Great Britain taking some buildings but over there, and then he has three units of Jedid Janissaries, so he's also bringing some pretty nasty melee units. Now let's move on to the other side. We're gonna go ahead and do a normal speed, because there is a little bit of a, you know, a slow spot during the beginning of this fight, so we're not gonna really miss much. So starting with Great Britain, he's mostly just spamming rifles and foot. He has lots and lots of foot stretched out through the almost the entire battlefield, it seems like. Lots and lots of foot moving into formation. In the back here, he has some light foot. He has some rifles scattered around. And then way in the back, he has some cav over here. So he's got some light dragoons. I love the uniforms here of the light dragoons. He has some horse guard. Pretty heavy cav there. And then he has the King German Legion Light Dragoons. So he got some German boys on the battlefield. Here's more Light Dragoons. So lots and lots of cav. And then here's his general staff on this flank of the battlefield. He also has some fencibles that are taking shelter in this building, which is a good idea. A great way to counter the Ottomans is holding up in buildings and firing from a distance, because that infantry, if it gets too close to your front line and you don't get enough volleys off, they are going to slaughter your men. Alright, so moving on to Russia, bringing mostly musketeers for his main infantry force, so about four units of musketeers. Actually, you know what, he's got about six units of musketeers, we got two more over here, and he is also bringing lots of cav, so he's got some mounted rifles. We're going to see a lot of mounted guns in this battle. He's also got some lancers and hussars with the nice orange uniforms. I love the uniforms, guys, you know that already. And I think he also has some grenadiers hidden in the trees, so look out for the grenadiers. Also, he has some Russian Jaegers. All right, so let's start this battle. there was a bit of a skirmish over here. The Ottomans are retreating. We really didn't miss much. Just a small little firefight. As you can tell, he's got some cav waiting, ready to ambush Great Britain. But both sides here just kind of looking at each other's armies, seeing what they can do in this situation. Now, it's pretty obvious that the Ottomans were very aggressive at the start of this fight, and they took the strategic hilltops here. The question is, are they going to just sit there and defend, or are they going to charge forward and try to take out Great Britain, who's holding up in the tree line, which is going to be pretty tough for Great Britain. I don't know why these players were so passive when it, you know, at the beginning of the fight, not moving up their army, not trying to fight for these hills. Oh, here's some shots, guys. Yeah, we got the light infantry firing down. It looks like some light foot over there. Oh, we got more light infantry in skirmish mode here. Getting some pretty good shots. That was a little careless from Great Britain. You gotta watch out for that kind of thing. You don't want to take any unnecessary casualties. But we do have some jetted infantry moving forward, so I do believe this battle is going to begin soon. I think the Ottomans are going to start this one and be the aggressive players, which is always good to see. In Napoleon, there's sometimes with players, they're very defensive, very just stand back and like hold a defensive position. I love to see very aggressive players in these kinds of situations, even though the Ottomans have the high ground, which even if they push forward, they still have the high ground over here. They got the cliffs. So all they have to do is just move forward, bring the fight to Great Britain. Let's see, what do we got over here? We got a nice flank going on with the Grenadiers. He has some jetted rifles. It looks like they're just kind of harassing some of the flank here of Great Britain. Let's see, what is he doing on this side? Oh, what is this? He's moving over some foot right in front of the Ottoman Empire. It's like he's taunting him. Oh, there we go. Some of the rifles are firing. I don't think they're getting any friendly fire because they're kind of firing up at an angle. So he is in range of the Ottomans. So pretty soon the Ottomans, they need to make a move here. They're moving up their cav forces. Let me go ahead and turn on the mini map so we can kind of see what's going on from like a bird's eye view, from a tactical view. Here we go. He's moving up his line infantry. He's not going to sit back and just lose men like that. He's going to bring the fight to Great Britain. And this battle is about to get really, really intense. There we go. Look at that. Shots fired. I hear some cav charging. I hear something charging. Oh, there's the counter volley from the jetted line infantry, doing lots and lots of damage. Very epic fight here from the tree line. So he's got his light foot in the front lines right behind. He's got his foot. Is he charged? Yes, he is charging in his Janissaries. So, and then he's using his light foot to hold the Janissary infantry. And then here comes another charge of foot. Joining this fight, bayonets first. It's time to get the bayonets bloody and take on this sworded infantry. So pretty sweet fight right here. He's got a couple units holding the line. He still has line infantry in the back here, firing from a distance, trying to take out the troops who are on this little hilltop here, which he is taking out a decent amount, but the infantry here is just wrecking lives. It is not looking good for Great Britain. He's got troops who are wavering. They just cannot take the melee capabilities of the Janissaries of the Ottoman Empire. So nice aggressive play from the Ottomans. We also have some cav over here fighting the light dragoons. I don't know if he might be not aware of the situation going on. But the guard here are just going to run on through. He's got more cav running through the force here, trying to take out that Great Britain flank. And there is a fight going on for the building over here. So he's charging forward, more and more Ottoman forces trying to take out this building, the strategic building, sending in the Grenadiers, which will clean out buildings very quickly. So there they go, charging into the buildings. Also, he's got his Bashi Bazooks in there. Bashi Bazooks. So a nice tree line battle. The Janissaries still going to town over here, still pushing forward, trying to clear out this tree line formation Oh, and then we've got some Cav support going in, taking out some of the rifles here. Great Britain is just getting crushed right now, which is not a good sign for them. So yeah, they're definitely getting taken out pretty quickly. Let's see, here comes some camel gunners. The demon camel gunners getting awfully close. They're getting super close. They're joining the melee here. So just a, you know, the floodgates of the Ottoman Empire was open upon Great Britain, and they just did not have the right tools to take them on. I mean, as soon as that melee joined the fight against Lightfoot, you knew it was going to be a bad situation, because there's no way that Lightfoot was going to be able to contain the Janissaries. So now the Janissaries are going to continue to run down the center, break through the center position of Great Britain. We have Cav charging over this way. We've got Russia now sending over some support. He's got two units of musketeers trying to form up, line up, and fire down at the flank of the Ottomans that are pushing a little too far for their comfort. And we also have mounted rifles from Russia melting the Delhi horsemen. So they're going to fall back and actually take on the general of Great Britain. And let's see the point of view here. Great Britain's, most of his army, what's left of it, is on this flank. As you can tell, there's some pretty intense Cav fighting. The general of Great Britain has been killed, so he is no longer on the battlefield. And just like that, Great Britain is getting destroyed. So it's all down to Russia. Can he turn the battle around? He certainly has the tools to do it. You know, mounted rifles to run around the battlefield. Lots and lots of good infantry, which are going to do very good against the Ottoman infantry. Russia's pretty good in melee. So, you know, they're going to get those bayonets ready. And they are breaking the will of the Janissaries. So hold that line, men. Hold that line. And it looks like they're going to fall back here, reform, and make sure that the Ottomans do not outflank them. As you can tell, the Ottomans are pushing down this way. We have another healthy unit of Ottoman forces that haven't even moved forward yet. So this is looking pretty rough for Russia. This is the epic last stand for the Russian Empire. He's moving over. Oh, yes. He's moving over his mounted rifles, trying to get them in range, trying to take out the Ottomans while they're occupied, you know, fighting Great Britain. And Great Britain's not done yet either. He's going to continue to fight and fight for his empire and help Russia as much as possible. So his foot taking on some of the Cav here. He's got his horse guard also taking on the Ottoman Cav. He's taking on the camels over here, those demon camels. And his mounted rifles, it looks like they're just trying to get in a good position to fire upon the Ottomans. He's got to be careful, though. He's getting shot by some skirmishers here. Let's see what's going on this side. Oh, we got a charge here from the Russian hussars going into some light infantry of the Ottoman Empire. So that was a really good move there, but he needs to quickly get these hussars out of the fight. He's also taking out some of... Whoa, what is this guy doing? Did you see that? The horse totally derped out over there. That was really goofy. But yeah, he's taking out some of the it's a mix of jetted infantry and Janissaries. But I think he needs to get his Cav out of there now. Get them out. It's too late now. More and more infantry joining this blob of a fight. We've got Russian rifles taking on more melee units, also fighting off some line infantry from the Ottoman Empire. Look at this. We got a couple troops here holding back the drummer over here. Oh, there goes the drummer. Stabbed in the gut, hit in the face with the butt of the gun. And we have, we got a nice Cav charge from the Ottoman Empire. It seems like this is becoming too much for the Russian Empire. Let's see what he can do here. He still has his mounted rifles kind of harassing the enemy on this flank. It looks like he charged in some of his rifles to try to take out some of the skirmishers of the Ottoman Empire. Let's go ahead and zoom over the battlefield, see what's going on. We got a very intense tree-line battle. Russia, it looks like Russia is losing this fight. He is breaking some of the Delhi horsemen, which is good thanks to the help of Great Britain's bodyguard here. You know, their general is dead, so you might as well just throw him in. The Russians are now breaking.
So they're going to fall back, and now Russia is preparing to hold his final stand. Let's go ahead and look at his army, see what he has left. He's got some musketeers over here. Let's see, he's got some lifeguard foot that we did not see at the beginning of the battle, so it's good that he has some elite troops, but he needs to get them in the fight because things are getting pretty serious, because in the tree line, he is holding with some Russian Jaegers, which will only hold for so long. Especially if the Ottomans move up their line infantry and get them in range. It's not going to be a pretty sight for these Russian Jaegers. Oh, what is this? Oh, he's got his grenadiers over here as well. So the very awesome grenadiers who just can't seem to get into formation. They're like, nope, nope, little to the left, little to the left, to the right. There we go. Okay, right, right there. Nope, not yet. What are they doing? They're glitching out. I don't know, maybe, I don't know. They're just terrified. They don't know what to do. So the Ottomans forming a long line over here. They're forming square formation because we do have a charge here from Delhi horsemen who are going after the general of Russia. I'm very glad that they are running, or Russia's running his general, because obviously he doesn't want to lose them just yet. So hopefully he survives this engagement. It looks like he is going to, because this unit is so depleted. Well, I don't know. It's actually pretty close. Russia needs to send some support over here quickly. And show that map there, that mini map. There we go. He's sending over some support. Oh man, his general was really close to dying. In fact, he's still close to dying. It's not over yet. He's got to break that unit. Oh, there we go. Oof. That was a close one. That could have been game over right there. But his line infantry now engaging the line infantry of the Ottoman Empire. So this is it, guys. The final stand of the Russian Empire. Their ally just really did not help too much. So it's up to the Russians to take victory here again, you know, while they're in the jaws of defeat. Oh, man. Come on, grenadiers. What is this? You need to form up. The trees are bugging them out. This is not good at all. He needs them firing as much as possible. Lots of line infantry really getting thinned out over here, like the auxiliaries. Let's see, some line infantry over here, which are not engaging just yet. So I assume that... Oh, there they go. There they go. They're firing at that very expensive grenadier unit. That's tough to watch, but the grenadiers are firing back. And they do have the shelter of the tree line here. So they do have some, you know, protection. And the Ottomans going for another charge on the backs of the musketeers. And the musketeers are actually running away. So he's going to do some kiting tactics here against these Janissaries. And they're going to continue to pursue. We can see the line infantry, the lifeguard afoot, protecting the musketeers as they fall back. And they are starting to break. The Janissary, the Ottoman Janissaries are starting to break. It looks like he's falling back. Not really sure. He's going to form square here and try to fire down. Let's see. Quick fire. Fire before they charge. I can't even speak straight. This is too intense. Too intense. Oh, there they go. They're charging in. Charging into the square formation of the musketeers. The lifeguard foot also firing down at these Janissaries. So the Ottoman's going to try to take him out. Oh, and then he gets a really good charge on the Russians, who are not paying attention. And the Hussars, they're actually, let's see, they're going to join the fight. Yes, they are. Oh, wait, no, they're going to run right past them. And they're going to try to give them a taste of their own medicine, charging into some line infantry. Here we go. Oh, beautiful charge there. The Ottomans are going flying. So I like that move. I really do. So instead of, you know, supporting his line infantry there, he just went ahead and charged one of the line infantry of the Ottomans, which is a really good maneuver. And his line infantry, of course, you know, since they're a lifeguard foot, they were able to hold against that cav charge. And he's going to get out of square formation and begin the firefight once again. So Russia's doing a good job here. He's not going out without a fight. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. All right, so here's some musketeers moving forward. Looks like he needs to try to support this house building, this strategic house defense. He's got some musketeers fighting some light infantry. They should be able to win that engagement, especially with the support of this musketeer unit. Let's see, what are they doing? Just form up and fire. Take out that Ottoman Jedet infantry. Quickly, quickly. So the Ottomans, if we get a bird's eye view of the fight, they are pushing on multiple flanks. But Russia is continuing to hold here. It looks like the line infantry here is starting to break. The morale is in orange. They're taking on those very deadly grenadiers and some skirmishers. Also, we've got some line infantry moving over this way. More auxiliaries moving into position. So what the Ottomans need to do to win this fight is just to attack. Like, don't... Like, I know that's, you know, pretty obvious. Like, oh, Apollo, he needs to attack. Go figure. No, but he needs to attack as a whole army. Just move in all of your forces at once. Don't attack in waves. Then you're just giving Russia the advantage. You just need to move your forces all together. And oh, Russia's going for a nice Hussar's charge here. But they are getting shot in the crossfire at the flank here. Not really the crossfire, but you know what I mean. They got shot down there by the Jedet line infantry, so that's not looking good for the Hussars. I assume they are done. They are off the battlefield, evaporated. They've seen too much action, and they need some rest. And now the line infantry. Oh, what's going on here? Oh, we got a charge here from the Jedet line infantry into the Russian Jaegers, who are holding very, very strong in the tree line. They got some nice camouflage here too. You know, the green uniforms kind of blend them in the trees. But unfortunately, they are breaking to the sight of the Jedet line infantry. But we do have some grenadiers in reserve holding back. We have some musketeers as well. So let's see if they can form up here. I would just charge in those grenadiers. Maybe use the grenades here, which I think they are. Are they using the grenades? Or are they going to fire their guns? Nope, they're going to continue to fire their guns. And the infantry is going to continue to push here. He might be out of ammo. Not really sure. But he needs to just throw in his... What is this? They're pushing them back. They're so goofy looking. There we go. What, they are sliding all over the battlefield. Look at this guy. He's like, don't mind me. I'm just going to slide you back in position. Yeah, the grenadier, look at that. Look how choppy the reload animation is. It's definitely bugging out in the tree line. And the auxiliaries are really trying to fire on the flank here, trying to weaken the Russian last stand. If I was Russia, I would push forward my line infantry and try to take out these forces here, because I think Russia has the advantage. There we go. He's reading my mind. He's listening. He's moving up his lifeguard afoot, which is a really good unit. Should be able to wipe these guys out very quickly. You got to use that superior infantry. Ooh, yeah. They are going to get the first shot there, but once your men are firing, I think the tables will turn. But the Ottomans are pushing on this side. The Russians were able to hold over here, which is really surprising. It looks like it was kind of going downhill. But here comes a charge from the Ottoman Empire, really trying to take out this Russian defense. And Russia, man, he's putting up a great stand. Fantastic stand. And then on the other side, yes, the lifeguard afoot are breaking the Ottomans. Does Russia have enough? Can they hold? I don't know. I mean, they've got to hold in the center, which it doesn't look like they are going to be able to. What he needs to do is quickly beat them on this flank and then move his infantry towards the center to reinforce that side. So hurry up, guys. Let's fire. Move on to the next target. Let's see. Come on, lifeguard foot. You want to win this battle. It's all right here. You've got to do something about this. Oh, he's got some line infantry breaking. This is not good. The Russian center position is wavering. Too many forces. And now he's got some cav flank. He needs to form square. The general is right there. If he can take out the general, he can win this battle. Cause a chain rout in the Ottoman ranks. But it seems like it's all down to his lifeguard foot. Which is a good unit to, you know, to rely on. But he's got more and more Russians. Oh, nope. That was the Russian general. Russian general has been slain by, I believe, the Ottoman general. This is not good for the Russian Empire. He's got his grenadiers forming square, taking on all kinds of different charges from different flanks. Oh, man. Not good at all. Come on, grenadiers. Hold, you brave, brave souls. Remember your mustaches. Fight for your mustaches. Your beautiful mustaches. And then now the general is engaging the lifeguard afoot, which is... Oh, the general was slain. It's not over yet, guys. It is not over yet. In fact, both Ottoman generals are fighting against the lifeguard afoot. Hope, there is still hope in this fight. They can still win this engagement. The grenadiers are holding the line. They are stopping this Ottoman advance, and they might be able to turn this battle around. Now they're firing their guns, trying to take out what's left of the line infantry. Let's see what happens here. This is an insane last stand. Yep, they're holding. You gotta kill this general. Just kill him. He's breaking. He is so close to breaking from the battlefield. I think this is the unit, though, that the general was killed in. So it's not really a big deal. I think this is the last general on the battlefield. All other generals have been killed in action. So there we go. They're gonna finish off that unit there. Reform. Hold. Let's see if he can... Yeah, he needs to fall back. He is falling back. He needs to regroup his forces and try to kill off what's left of the Ottoman Empire. This is going to be insanely close. The balance of power is in favor of the Ottoman Empire, but only just barely. So let's go ahead and close out some of these annotations here. What a match, guys. I thought this was going to be super one-sided, but no, Russia is turning this around. So win or lose, I just want to give, you know, tip my hat to Russia for putting up an epic stand here. He's moving up his lifeguard afoot. Hopefully this unit doesn't break here. They need to continue to fire. He's chasing down some rifles who are retreating, so he might be doing some kiting tactics here. But he's got to watch out for the center position. Let's see. It looks like they mostly have line infantry over here on this side. So the two line infantry units are facing off over here. I can't even talk right now. The two units, they don't really want to push forward and start the fight. They want to hold their ground. Russia, though. Oh, Russia's going to... Well, this is actually a smart idea from the Ottoman Empire. They're taking shelter in this building, but the lifeguard afoot, they're going to try to quickly charge in there. Try to take them out. Come on, charge. Don't slow down. Keep going. Keep going. So there they go. And then... Oh, he's trying to snipe out the general who's running by. He does take out some of the bodyguard, but it's not going to be enough. And it looks like he's going to escape the reach of the lifeguard afoot. Now, oh, we've got rifles trying to leave the building. So they could actually hold up over here for a pretty long time. So are they running? It says combat winning slightly. I don't know. I don't know if Russia has enough here. Honestly, what Russia should do is just hold up in here. Like, they should take the building and fight off the Ottomans, which would be pretty epic, I'm not gonna lie. So there we go. Oh, the general charging in. This is his chance. Can they kill the Ottoman general? Yes, yes, they do. They killed the Ottoman general. This is insanely close. This is such a great battle. Man, is Russia gonna turn this around? I don't know. He's so greatly outnumbered. The balance of power is still shifting in the Ottomans' favor. It's still pretty close. It's pretty much the same. But here comes the Ottoman horde, or what's left of the Ottoman horde, ready to take out this building. There goes the general. His entire unit has been slain. And then here is the final stand of this lifeguard foot. Does he only have one unit? Yes, he does. The other unit is breaking right here. We can see them running away. Why, men? Why break? Now he's taking on some melee units. Oh, he's able to break them right here. Here comes another charge of line infantry. They really need to fire them down. Try to take out as many men before they engage in melee. Let's see. I don't know. The morale is still pretty solid for the lifeguard foot. The morale over here is pretty bad for the Ottoman Empire. So there we go. There you have it. And then the grenadiers are joining back in the fight. So they're coming over here to take on some of the light infantry. And this is it. Whoever wins this engagement right here, I think potentially will win the battle. My goodness. My goodness. And then the Ottomans are leaving the positioning over here. So, excuse me, the Russians are going to fall back as well and send over some troops to follow these guys into the final stand here. But the grenadiers, they're doing everything they can to get in position, but the light infantry, they're just not having it. Not having it whatsoever. And oh no, this is not good. He's got some jetted rifles behind the Russian grenadiers. So let's go ahead and look at the point of view of the Russian grenadiers. And they are running back and forth. So they're just, They're in a bad situation. They're in a really bad situation. They need to quickly break these rifles. But I think what's going to happen here is that the Ottomans are just going to run back and forth and cause this grenadier unit to, to just constantly be running back and forth, trying to fight on both flanks. What he should do is just send these grenadiers into this fight, into this the fight in the building here. But here comes the grenadiers. They're going to line up here, try to fire back at these jetted rifles. Let's see. Pretty soon. Actually, he's just charging. He might be out of ammo, so that is not a good sign for Russia. But remember, he still has two units over here who are taking their time. Oh, nope, it's not looking good for Russia. Russia just lost control of the house here. The grenadiers were able to catch up to these rifles, so they are fighting in melee. They do cause the jetted line infantry to break, and now they're going to charge inside the building and try to regain this building, which they will desperately need. But the balance of power is not looking good for the Russians, and I believe Russia will be defeated here today. But what a close one. It's still too close to say. You never know what can happen. These Russians here are going to charge into the forest, and the grenadiers, I don't think they're going to have enough troops to take out this position. So there they go. You can see them charging inside the building here. It's pretty close, guys. Oh no, the grenadier. Look at that morale. It is going away very quickly, and we have more Ottoman support charging in this way. But what a stand! What an absolute crazy stand from the Russian Empire. He did a fantastic job. He didn't give up, which I love to see. Even though his ally was like wiped out in seconds, he was able to hold his ground, do some very strategic strategies. Glorious victory for the Ottoman Empire. So really, really great matchup. Very, very close. And that's going to be it for Russia. So good game to all players. This was a fantastic match. And let's go ahead and check out the army comps, or not the army comps, but the stats here. So I believe this was sent in by Barbaros. So I do appreciate the battle replay, man. This was a fantastic one. Good game to Mike Knight 101. Maybe it was sent in. I don't know. Yeah, it was sent in by Barbaros. So I appreciate it so much. If we can look here, Russia got the most kills, which is no surprise there. Great Britain got about 1,000. And then both Ottoman players doing pretty well. It's a pretty close battle. I mean, look at these kills. Very, very close. But the Ottomans just barely got more. But if we look at the unit stats, the most kills here, no surprise. His melee units, his Janissaries, getting over 150 kills. 183, 147, 144 from his Grenadiers. So, great match. His Camel Gunner's getting 62 kills. So, he's 6 kills from one of his rifles, which is not great. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this battle, be sure to leave a like, a comment, and share. And if you haven't subscribed and you want to see more epic battles like this one, be sure to subscribe. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one, and I will see you next time.